Dairak.
Yes, I like.
Do you like Sonic Youth?
Yes.
You like Sonic Youth?
Yeah!
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 Yeah.
Yes, Sonic Youth!
You like Sonic Youth?
Yeah.
Do you like Sonic Youth?
Eh? Ah! Daisuki, daisuki, daisuki.
ソニーミュージックテレビ TV ソニックユーもちろん大好き大好きアイライアイライト Thank you Thank you
My brother came over to my house and tuned my acoustic guitar into some weird tuning and started playing and he left it tuned and it wasn't weird tuning it was kind of an open tuning of some sort not too far away from some of our tunings soI immediately wrote maybe four or five songs on this guitar and this tuning. I felt like completely inspired by it. And I was planning on doing a solo record of this music. I felt they were somewhat unfinished somehow. And I knew for a fact that if I had given them to the band would take them and transform them into like a unified band composition.
It's all sort of worked out over time in here and we,Sort of, it's sort of like sculpture in a way. We build the things up, we play with the structures, we change things around. People keep notes in different ways. Here's some pages in my notebook for some of the stuff from Murray Street. I've got a little stamp that makes the guitar neck so I can put finger position since when we play with all these different tunings, these aren't very interesting pages, when we play with all these different tunings,There's, you know, you got to make up the chords as you go along. So we work on the structure over time, and everybody kind of has their own way of notating stuff. And we just kind of work it out.
Switch and these kind of pedals that come with some other pedals they also use three pole and if I connect then I can wire a whole bunch of pedals that usually you can't control with anything but the knob and then I can have them all be controlled by one pedal all I have to do is make one master if you kind of just go through them you usually findWhy it does that, but immediately, you know, you can get these sounds it's not supposed to make.
I know that when I saw Almost Famous with Thurston, there were parts where he was, you know, nearly in tears when he was thinking about, you know, could have beens, you know, could have been there for Zep, could have been there for, you know, this scene, that scene. You know, he's a little bit behind the eight ball on that, and it's never really gotten past him. I know that when Albini was recording you know, the page and plant thing. You know, Thurston was always offering to come out. He's like, oh, Steve, I haven't seen you for a long time. You know, maybe we could get together. You know, I'd like to come out, maybe do some work. You could show me around your studio. And, you know, it's tough for Steve to keep him out of there, really. And so the empty page, I think, has a lot to do with that.
These are the words, but not the truth. God bless them all when they speak to That's all right on an empty stage.
you're here to stay. Sing out tonight the empty page. I always thought I'd see your name in fashion light. You did it all for
they could be voodoo dolls. We don't have any pins, but some fan made a set of dolls of the four of us. This is Steve. This is Thurston. This is Kim. Mine got lost before we left the gig that night, so we don't have the Lee doll anymore. And of course, there wasn't a Jim one back then.
It's just like Jim's solo stuff stands alone. His interpretation of what Sonic Youth are doing added a new dimension to it. I mean, it's so obvious on the new record, but I think now they've got to the sound that I've been sort of wanting them to get to. It's just, they're gonna give a lot of bands a run for their money.
I'm gonna go upstairs and fix my package.
Hey, there was a disc in your drive, Jim.
Really?
Lee, and I was trying to say, like, don't look at Lee, look at me.
I should
okay.
hold off on that.
No, you should look
play,
at him.
You should be playing Town 10 Windmills there, and I'll show you what you should be playing.
Oh, okay.
It starts playing with the feet slightly but larger apart than the shoulders.
Okay. Play, like,
A arm sharp. Extended full length.
A sharp.
And A sharp.
I'm ready for your brutality. I'm ready
Say when.
For your brutality.
Okay, rolling. Well, before we got into it, it should have calmed down, I thought.
Okay. When I do that riffy thing, were you joining before?
Yeah, when I was playing guitar, yeah.
Like, oh, that's that?
You're not doing that anymore.
Like, you know, you can double it. I think it'd be good.
Yeah, we can do that later.
I think as soon as Kim introduces that thing, we should come down into it, though.
I'm not going to do that.
That's what I'm doing before.
Yeah, but that's...
And then I start with my next note is.
Yeah, but we can't cut that there then if you don't hit the cymbals because it's gonna be like shh. They're just gonna
cut on my. You can't cut on the first.
But there's gonna be no decay from the cymbal. They're just gonna be like.
But
well,
when we do it for real, we're doing like.
Hey!
And then on a count we go to this new noise. You don't do any. You don't do a crash there.
I go to the tom and snare, which I did.
Okay.
Okay, we can do it that way.
Do we need to worry at the end of the whole thing about all the buzzing background noise?
No.
I get rid of my buzz at the end.
Your buzz was very prominent.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I had it on.
There's a lot of stuff that goes on when Sonic Youth makes a record. Mainly we just get together in this room. We all pick up instruments and start playing and just kicking out a bunch of jams. Sometimes someone will bring in a fragment or an idea. Thurston often brings in sort of the basis of some chord changes that he's got going on. And basically we sit in here for a few months and kick the stuff around. Everybody contributes. Everybody's equally involved in the final writing of the music. And we put it together here.
What I really like about the new album is that it's like they're continually evolving, and if you take elements of like the some of my favorite records like Daydream Nation and Dirty and Goo and stuff, and just like, and you're bringing it all together, but just they sound like a band that are making sort of like, they've got fresh ideas constantly, and those ideas sort of like sound great, and they're making great records as opposed to sort of like old dinosaurs that keep playing and don't like make good records. And there's plenty of bands like that.
Oh, yeah, he's awesome. I like this thing.
Dude, man, how many people jizzed on this thing?
Oh, see, look. This is how it's supposed to be like that. You'd have to cover it, recover it. I like this one. Let's see. That's amazing how much light is, like, when you look over, like, how much light comes down here now.
We sort of looked at our own little portion of the city here where we had to struggle so hard to get back in after September and try and figure out how we were going to pick up the pieces and finish the record. And I think it maybe made us look at with a new appreciation at the place we work, the city we live in. And so the idea of calling the record something as straightforward as Murray Street was seemed to make a lot of sense to us. Thurston had just bought a little digital camera and he was out taking pictures, and he took a couple pictures of the street sign that used to be on this corner where we're at that said Murray Street, and he brought it up to show us and said, look, don't you think this would make a great album cover? And it's subsequently the back cover of the record.
This is the Murray Street sign. And south, that's where the towers used to be. It's the street they tore up a million times. It's near a doll. Look, a strip club.
Tired of the times I wound up dead. Tired of the dogs inside your head. Tired of the needles beside your bed. Tired of the crap you keep me fed. Tired of the people you keep misled. Your blood is turning my blue eyes red. Get your hands on my tomato. Cherry juice on a rotten potato. Subway slasher is on my ass. Steals my money, smokes my grass. Watch your back or your dead meat, baby. Throw the dog a bone and it's still good rabies. Plastic girl, plastic gun. Plastic smile under plastic sun. You burn my heart with your frigid stare. Rip me off with your greasy hair. I hate you and fishy friends. I hate you and it never ends.
Each person who sings writes their own lyrics.
Although Thurston wrote the lyrics to Plastic Sun.
Although I wrote the lyrics to Plastic Sun, which Kim sings. But that happens once in a while.
It's fun to sing, like, you know, when he writes for my point of view or something, and it really fools people. And yeah, it's also kind of, I don't know, I just think it's really funny.
Sometimes I write him as if I'm sort of a kind of like a feminist.
Pissed woman.
A pissed woman, not a feminist, a pissed woman.
That song that we originally did for Jane Magazine. And I mean, I always took the lyrics to be kind of like about how fashion magazines package that attitude in girls, like that it was something.
No,
like,
actually, I wrote the lyrics as if I was Pat Place in 1979, 78 actually.
Anybody who knows Thurston particularly well knows that he's probably never really imagined himself as anything else. You know, Thurston copped, if not half his moves, I'd say three quarters of his move from Pat Place. You know, Pat was a very credible songwriter in her day.
My brother's guitar out there.
It's busted. It needs busted.
I think the neck is cracked.
How is that show?
Like here, look, it's all cracked. That's why it's all floppy. It doesn't hold the tuning.
Bummer. Why don't we just smash it on camera right now?
Why don't we?
Next song is entitled Plastic Sun.
No.
Oh, I'm sorry. This next song is titled Radical Adults, Lick Godhead Style.
The style of God.
Radical Adults, Lick, and It Got a DeVita.
Street. I actually like this little piece of paper that you sent out. I think it's quite. I like the little historical perspective.
Right. Is that Byron's piece? Or
I don't know.
Byron Coley.
He wrote about your lies.
It's kind of a method that some other people have used. Take five or six songs, you just cut them down, keep cutting them down on cassette, and then once it's done, you have the whole thing sort of put together. Radical Adults. You know, it's funny because that in a way. Crafts two of the weirder things together. I mean, there's a bunch of it I think is kind of based on some of the Juarez, just kind of a country opera written by the video artist Terry Allen from Texas. I think I've got it up here. Yeah. Most of the lyrical borrowings that were taken on here were done by cut-up. So they don't necessarily pop out that easily. But I can remember them borrowing this record at that time. There was another electronic part that was more, was kind of the American Indian electronic part, though. This is the period when Buffy St. Marie had a little electronic flowering with Peter Schickley from PDQ Bach. And I know that that had a big influence on Kim. She said when she lived in Hawaii that really her family listened to a lot of Buffy St. Marie all the time together, and that they would do a lot of Buffy St. Marie style singing. And at the same time, she was starting to get into electronic music, so she would sometimes play some sort of a crude synthesizer along while the family did Buffy St. Marie songs. And that when this album came out, that was really integral to, you know, the way that she thought that songs would be put together.
You're playing. You got the DVD player open. Do you see your thing that says DVD player? So quit that.
Do Apple Q now before you're killed.
Okay, I'm gonna tickle you, please.
I'm
Why don't we just cancel the tour and like play with our computers all summer?
And we can answer the phone and check email.
I don't think I want a tour now. Okay, I'll play a song with his old horrible songs. Let's play new stuff. Let's write a new song. I have a couple ideas.